you know, I just wanted to talk about the Real Housewives of Atlanta, the episode that just premiered. I forgot the episode. This is my thing. First of all, Todd. Todd is a trifling ass, sorry ass nigga. How are you gonna quit your motherfucking job for a bitch? You got two motherfucking kids. You mean to tell me that you were so infatuated with Portia that you just don't give a fuck about providing for your kids? I don't want to hear shit about no savings. I don't want to hear shit about what you got in your checking account. The point of the matter is you have two kids and you quit your job to be with a woman. What? And then on top of that, bitch, I don't blame. Now, y'all ain't gonna hear me give Portia too many props because I don't fuck with Portia like that. But I don't blame Portia. I'm in the same way, like, hold on. What you mean you quit your motherfucking job? You just quit your job? You quit your job because of... Baby, you can look at Portia and tell Portia ain't no cheap-ass bitch. So, Todd, how are you going to take care of Portia or take care of your responsibilities or take care of a family that y'all supposed to be trying to work on? You ain't got no goddamn job. Now, I know Portia not pregnant right now. But at the end of the day, you just can't go be up around quitting your motherfucking job when you already got two kids and you may have one on the way. You see what I'm saying? Like, I just understand that. That shit is trifling to me. Todd don't get no kudos for quitting your job for a woman, especially when you got two motherfucking kids. Now, if you just single and you ain't got no responsibilities but your damn self, then go ahead and live your life the way you want to live. But when you already got kids, you basically putting the bitch before your kids. Y'all like that shit. Not with Portia. At the end of the day, Todd can be the nicest person in the motherfucking world, but that potential shit goes out the window. It goes out the window in your goddamn 20s. Portia is a 35-year-old woman. Portia is done with potential. You leave that potential to those bitches in their early teens. 19, 20, 21. Oh, he got potential. I'm going to stick with him. 25, maybe. But bitch, once you start getting 25 or 26, that potential shit is for the motherfucking birds. Especially a bitch in her goddamn 30s. I don't blame Portia, bitch. I'm too grown to be around here with a goddamn man who ain't got no goddamn job. What else? I love the fact that that Kenya and Phaedra, the first 30 minutes, I was just like, it was actually very, very nice just to see. Because, you know, when we watch reality TV, we like to see the shade and the read and the drama. But it was actually nice just to get a break. And then on top of that, not only with the fact that they were not arguing and fighting, it was actually very entertaining. Like, oh, okay, this is cute. I don't know if I want to see that every week, but it was cute for those first 30 minutes. Cynthia goes and stays with Candy because she's pretty much, you know, homeless. Cynthia pulls up with toilet tissue and air freshener and cereal. And I'm not going to lie, I'm just like Cynthia. I remember I had to stay with one of my friends for like a week until my new apartment was ready. This is some years ago. And, I had toilet tissue and soap and everything. And she was like, why the fuck are you bringing toilet tissue? Bitch, like, nigga, I got toilet tissue. I was like, girl. She was a female. She's one of my best friends. She a real. I know y'all be like, because I call everybody girl. But she's an actual girl. she was like, why the fuck you bringing toilet tissue and shit? I'm like, girl, I just don't want no problem. You know, but I go places, I need to make, I don't want no problems with nobody. Like, I brought my own shit. I don't want you talking about, you know, Rodney came and stayed with me. He used up all my soap. He used all my toilet tissue, my toothpaste. He ate my food. Then he left when the week was up. So I don't blame Cynthia for that. I thought that was actually kind of funny. What else? Okay, so they get to the dinner table and I'll say this much. Portia does not like Kenya. For me, Kenya looks at this as a job and that is it. So she doesn't have a problem being around Portia because she knows at the end of the day, that's her job. They have to be around each other. In real life, the truth of the matter is, if you didn't like a bitch, you're not going to be around that bitch. The first thing you're going to say is when your good Judy invites you out, to, like I said before, when your good friend invites you out, you know, and they be like, oh, well, you know Ashley gonna be there. Bitch, I don't fuck with no motherfucking Ashley. You know I don't fuck with that bitch. I ain't going around that hoe. I have to slap that bitch in her goddamn face. That's the first thing you're gonna say. But because of the job that they have, they don't have a choice. So I think for Kenya, she just looks at it like, okay, girl, this is my job. I don't have no problem with Portia. But Portia really hates Kenya. And I still cannot understand why. Because at the end of the day, Portia, you dragged Kenya. Well, y'all, like y'all said, she dragged, even though she didn't drag because she pulled her hair off. She dragged Kenya. So if anything, bitch, Kenya should hate your motherfucking guts. So anyways, Kenya starts to ask her, you know, how's the anger management going? Because Phaedra did tell her that she wanted to talk to the group about her sessions or whatever. And, you know, Phaedra basically lied and said that she never told Kenya that. But anyways, they start to get into it. And so I honestly think that Candy was just trying to say, okay, I think in Candy's head, like, okay, bitch, we know Portia don't like you, so let me just ask, like, how is your anger management going? Then all of a sudden, Candy got into it. And I'm with Candy on this, like, bitch, you coming at me when I'm just trying to just ask a question, because the truth of the matter is, bitch, this is the thing with Portia. Portia does not like to accept responsibility for the shit that she's done. Even, she's bringing up shit like what happened when her and Kenya first got into their altercation. Well, don't forget you put that thing in my... That's clearly that one session that you went to for anger management is not working. Because to this very day, you still don't want to accept the responsibility on your half. Like King said, bitch, I apologize to you. You never apologize to me, that's fine. But at the end of the day, you started bringing up shit from, what, 3-4 years ago. Girl, let that shit go. The truth of the matter is, Portia, people don't want to be around you because, bitch, you will nuck. Hello? And I'm tired of people saying, oh, well, Kenya can be around Matt, but she feels in danger of being around Portia. The truth of the matter is, it's a lot of y'all bitches out there right now who are with niggas, who will curse y'all out, who will push y'all into walls, who will throw y'all onto beds. They may not necessarily have punched you in your goddamn face or backhanded your ass, but at the end of the day, they still put their motherfucking hands on you. And you still go back to those same goddamn niggas. And then there might be a bitch out there who you just don't even want to motherfucking be around. It's the same motherfucking thing. And the truth of the matter is, as crazy as I think Matt is, I said Matt was crazy from the motherfucking get-go when I heard about him breaking shades and knocking down doors. She should have let that motherfucker a long time ago. But the truth of the matter is, from what we know, he has never actually put his hands on her, even though I think that's what have eventually happened. But he has never put his hands on Kenya. So, of course, Kenya may, of course, because she's in a relationship with this man, she may give him a little bit more leeway than a bitch who she really don't fuck with like that. And then Sheree, from what Kenya says, and I believe Kenya, Sheree probably more than likely has been in an abusive relationship, if Kenya says that, I just believe it. And then all of a sudden she tries to, Sheree tries to say that Kenya said that Kenya tried to make light of domestic violence situation when it was really Sheree. Sheree was the one who sat right there in that parking lot and said, basically, you know, you provoke Matt to do the stuff that he does. That's another thing I cannot stand. I'm tired. I said this in my last video. I'm tired of y'all bitches out here always trying to defend these trifling ass no good niggas. I don't give a fuck if Kenya yelled to the top of her lungs at Matt, telling him he's a sorry trifling ass nigga. That still don't give him no right to go around busting out people motherfucking windows in their car, breaking shit in their house, knocking down doors. He got arrested 4 times in 1 year. He pulled a taser out of his goddamn body and ran off in the bushes. Like, ain't nobody, we are all motherfucking grown. We are all grown. I have been called every name in the motherfucking book. And I have never put my hands on nobody. Now I might cuss your motherfucking ass out. I'll cuss your ass out from here to Mexico. But the truth of the matter is, for y'all to sit here and defend and try to say, oh, well, Kenya, you like to provoke people. You like to provoke people. I'm not going to sit here and say Kenya is innocent. I mean, Kenya is innocent. I'm not going to say that. But when y'all start talking about these big-ass niggas, and she provoked Matt to do the shit that he do. Y'all full of shit. And y'all are the main reasons why these grown-ass men be walking around here acting the way they act. Still are calling these motherfuckers out. Y'all done got caught up into Black Lives Matter, which I support 100%. Y'all done got caught into Black Lives Matter. Y'all think that, that means we're going to let these sorry-ass niggas be sorry-ass niggas. No. If you put your hands on somebody, if you do some shit, if you break some shit, if you break people's shit, breaking glass in people's house, bitch, you going to jail. On my clock, you are anyways, girl. I don't give a fuck what nobody say. Anyways, Portia comes back and she tries. Portia ends up leaving because she's tired of those bitches and she looked a mess to me too. And Portia, I ain't gonna lie, even though I don't too much care for Portia, I will say she always be put together. But for some reason, girl, I was like, girl, where are you going? You got an all black and leather and a fedora and all types of shit in the middle of the day. Okay, girl, whatever. You can tell that those scenes last a very long time. Bitch, it didn't look like it was afternoon when they got there. And bitch, it didn't look like it was 10 o'clock when they left. Them bitches get paid a lot of money, so I guess they ain't got no choice. But anyways, so Portia leaves, and then she comes back, and she starts to tell Phaedra that she needs to watch Kenya, because Kenya's not to be trusted. The truth of the matter is, I guarantee you, besides people hating Kenya because they thought that she was trying to fuck Apollo, and Apollo lied the whole damn time, and people still dislike her for that, y'all really can't say that Kenya is somebody who's not to be trusted. What has Kenya done that shows you that she's not to be, like, to the truth of the matter is, bitch, I wouldn't trust Phaedra or Portia over any of those bitches. Portia is the same bitch who sat here and talked about Candy for telling an ex-friend's business, but then she will sit right there in front of Sheree with Phaedra and tell her current friend's business, Shamia. When Phaedra started talking about, Candy fucking Shamia and Shamia fucking Todd, they all having threesomes, Portia didn't say, Phaedra, I don't think you should talk about that. I don't have nothing to do with that. Phaedra, maybe you should say that right now. You know what Portia did? Portia was like, yeah, they all kind of close. So you gonna do this to your mother, to the bitch who you brought him to the motherfucking show? The bitch who's supposed to be your motherfucking homegirl? Bitch, I don't trust you, Portia. I don't trust you, Phaedra. Anyways, and it pretty much went off like that.